welcome to tonight's video recap. We hope you enjoy everything that we're bringing to you tonight. We are really fortunate to have Zoe and Tilda, who are power riders for Australia. Now, Tilda, tell us about your horses and what classes you've been riding in.
Yeah, so I'm riding the Grade 4 Power Equestrian classes on two horses. One is a mare called Devil's Chocolate, and the other...
Great name.
Yeah, no, she's brilliant. And what's funny is her name is Tilly.
Ah.
So it's quite a similar name, so meant to be. Yeah, and then my other horse is Quebec. And so we've been doing the classes here just to get more experience, and it's great that Bonia holds these events so the powers can get much needed exposure. And yeah.
So what are your plans? Are you going to another event after this?
Well, my overall main goal is to go towards Tokyo.
So sounds good.
Yeah, so I'm working towards that, and I think in the meantime just doing as much events as possible, you know, Para Equestrian, Dressage Festival, Bonia, and just sort of get the miles on the board.
Well, fantastic. And Zoe, tell us about your horse.
So I'm also in the Grade 4 with Tilda. I've got...
Oh, who won? Who won today?
Tilda did, actually.
Oh, well,
thank
done.
You.
Well done, Tilda.
It was a great test.
She's nice.
But yeah, I've got two horses in as well, so both of us are a bit run off our feet, I think. I've got my little Brave in the Grade 4, and I've had him for 3 years now. And I've got my new boy, Walter, or Grand Calypso is his proper name. And both of them were pretty good, so I'm happy with it.
And you're both competing in this class that we're live streaming today?
Yes, the individual championship test.
And after this, any plans event-wise?
Yeah, same with Tilda. We're aiming for Tokyo, but our next big event will be at Equitana, actually.
Is that the first time Equitana have included para?
Yeah, which is really exciting. So we've got... three demonstrations, like education sessions,
wow,
in the pavilions, where we'll go through things like classification, compensation aids, judging, how to, you know, coach a para rider, finding a para suitable horse.
Fascinating.
Yeah, and things all the way through that riders can get involved with, and from grassroots to high performance, because we want to show that the sport develops all the way through. You know, you're not just looking at the Olympics. There's lots of steps before that, because sometimes thinking, oh God, the Paralympics, that's a bit intimidating. Maybe. So, you know, there's a pathway and there are various options for all riders. Yeah.
Great. Well, good luck to both of you. Enjoy today's competition, and thank you again to our sponsors, Equitana, for providing today's live streaming. We're very lucky to have here during the break, Bridget. Now, Bridget, tell me, what is your horse's name and how long have you been riding for?
My horse is called Coraline Sunrise, or Sunny for short. We started riding together in March this year.
Wow, such a short time.
Yeah, it's a very quick process, but it all just happened so easily and naturally. So we've been working hard to get here today, which is really quite exciting for us.
Is this your first time at a Nationals?
Yes. So this time last year, I was actually classified. So now I'm here riding as a para rider, which is great.
Oh, congratulations. And so what is it like to be at your first Nationals?
Very exciting. Just being at Bonnie Oak Park, it's like so wonderful. And to be here with all the other high-level riders and able-bodied riders, it's really quite something. I'm not used to it.
It is. The facilities are beautiful. And were you happy with how your horse Sunny went today?
Yeah, really happy, especially the second test. I was very nervous the first time, relaxed into it, and the second test was a lot better. We were really happy with how we went today.
Well done. Now, Bridget, have you got any other competitions coming up?
Our next big event will be Equitana. Sunrise and I are doing the para dressage demonstrations there.
And is that just one day, or when's that on?
Oh, we'll be there Friday, Saturday and Sunday. So we're doing a written demonstration each day, as well as we're having a booth there so people can come up and learn about para dressage and ask questions.
Oh, fantastic. And tomorrow is your freestyle. So have you chosen your music?
Yes, we're doing a ride to music from the Greatest Showman, the movie, which is pretty exciting. It's my first ever freestyle, so coming.
Well, Bridget, we're really looking forward to seeing you live tomorrow. And again, we are very, very grateful for all our amazing sponsors that enable you all at home to be able to view this live stream. So to our principal sponsor, Equitana, and our three supporting sponsors, Bates, Foresight and Vale, thank you very, very, very much, because without you all, we couldn't live stream you today. And good luck tomorrow, Bridget.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
So we're very privileged and lucky to have the beautiful Joanne Formosa with us. We do nothing but laugh all the time. Now, we're on camera now, it's serious, okay? Gold medalist from the Olympics London 2000. Mm-hmm. I still remember it very well. I guess you remember it even better than I do.
I do remember it. It was an ups and down, but I had a ball. I remember telling Lee Pearson in 2006 I'll be coming out to get him, and I did.
You did, well and truly. Yep. That medal around your neck was fantastic. And then yesterday?
It just shows you my boy's got wings.
Poor Joanne didn't have the best ride. She's PB Worldwide, who's the most beautiful, beautiful chestnut stallion. Mm. He's actually, how old is he?
He's 24 going on 4.
So yesterday he decided in the corner, I didn't see it, but he had an absolute attack and did a whip around and threatened to have a big hump and a carry on, which is so beautiful, but probably not really the perfect timing, but better than doing it at London.
Well, London, he had a lot of photographers around and he's not going to put a foot wrong. Here he had no one watching him because the boy's only got style when there's people around. But no, he was just showing him that he's fit and healthy and look what I can do.
So, well, you've got a couple of years to work in down before Tokyo.
Yeah, I'm looking for another horse for Tokyo. I don't mind a bit of zing, but not in the dressage arena.
Before you go, of course, there's people that you'd like to thank, and especially people that support you, because that's really important for any athlete, and you've got a group of sponsors.
I do. I have Magic Tails, Pride's Easy Feeds, Horseland, and Flexible Fit. And I'd like to thank, with all my heart, Julia Batten.
We all love
She's
her.
She's super coach, super person.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Good on you, Joanne.
And my horse.
Well, sometimes. So thank you. And thank you, Joanne. And really good luck in the future. And thanks to all your sponsors for helping me out. And you never know your luck.
I never know. We'll get there.
Thanks, Joanne. I have with me Brett Parbery, 10 days back from Trion and WEG. Congratulations, Brett. What a fantastic job. And Walt Meiser was just super, as always.
Yeah, look, he's great. He's the most honest, reliable, fabulous horse. So, you know, we had a great time. And as a team, and I think I can speak on behalf of the other team members, Christy Oatley and Mary Hannah and Alexis, that we were very happy with what we achieved. And we felt like we really did a good thing for Australia, and we represent Australia well, given where we're at.
And qualify for Tokyo.
Qualify for Tokyo. So now the goal is to, you know, it's only 20 months to Tokyo. It's not long at all. Actually, it might be less, because it's in July 2020. So everybody has to stay focused for Tokyo. So
do you have a horse in mind for Tokyo?
I do. Look, it's hard to know because you never know what's sure. But I've got two horses that I would like to prepare for Tokyo, maybe even three. But yeah, it's always hard. Always hard to know.
Cool. So Willinga Park's going well. I know you're riding horses down there and training, coaching out of Willinga Park. It's a super venue. Just like Bonio Park is just exceptional as well. And the job they've done today is really, really good. So we really look forward to this competition this afternoon and good surfaces. So Willinga Park is also working hand in hand a bit with Bonio.
Absolutely. Like, we... I think it's important that the major venues all work together, because that's what creates the fabric for the Australian equestrian industry, whether it's dressage or show jumping or if any. So, I 100% support Fiona and her family and what they're doing. And I think I can speak on behalf of Willinga Park and the Snow, Terry Snow and the family there, that we're here to support. And that's why I wanted to be here and help Fiona. I mean, aside from that, she's a very good friend, been a long-time friend of ours, and we've just loved what she's doing for the sport. So
yeah, there's certainly an exception behind us. I don't think you guys can see, but there's a fabulous cafeteria and a judges area and a huge viewing platform upstairs that overlooks the show jumping area on the other side and the main area here. It's a fantastic concept. So I say congratulations on your fantastic effort at WEG. And competitions coming up?
No, not for me. I don't have any shows really planned. I'm actually taking a break from riding for a little while to focus on some other things that I have on. But I'll be definitely back in the competition arena in 2019.
Well, we look forward to that. And again, congratulations to you, and pass on our congratulations from Equestrian Life and everyone out here to all the other competitors. We're so great watching you, as you well know from all the tweets and Facebook stuff. It's been fantastic. And congratulations, Australian team, and again representing Australia after WEG in Kentucky, and now another feather in your cap. Congratulations, and we look forward to seeing you riding really soon in 2019. Thanks for your time, Brett.
Thank you, Roger. Thank you.
We're very lucky to have here today Fiona Selby, who's Managing Director of Borneo Park. Fee, congratulations on another wonderful year for the Dressage Nationals at Borneo Park. What an achievement for Borneo Park.
Thank you very much, Sunday. Well, I must say it does get a little bit easier the second year around, but obviously this year we've got the added event of the Jumping Nationals in a couple of weeks' time. So it's a very, very busy time for our team at Borneo Park. But so far, a great first day of competition, and the weather's actually been very kind to us. So I think a very good start with some wonderful tests we've seen today already.
And the great news about free entry and the Brett Parbery Mastercard class, how lucky are you, well, we all are, to have him give a masterclass fresh back from the World Equestrian Games. Fantastic.
Oh, Brett has been absolutely amazing. As much as we thought we were super organised come last weekend, of course, things never quite go to plan, and obviously extremely unfortunate with the sudden passing of Rudolph's father. But I think in true Aussie style, Brett Parbery has just absolutely stepped in at the last minute and is going to perform two absolutely amazing masterclasses on Friday and Saturday. And yes, free entry for everyone every day of the championship. So hoping to see big crowds here, everyone to come down to Borneo Park and see some of the best horses and riders in Australia here on the Mornington Peninsula.
Well, thank you, Fee, and to your family for all the investment that you do in equestrian for this country. We're so fortunate to have amazing facilities, amazing surfaces for all these riders, and a smile on your face whatever happens at an event.
Best day smiling.
It is really, really such an honour to be here. So thank you for having us all.
We have Maree Tomkinson with us, and Maree's been competing wildly all weekend with her good mare Donna Elaine. She's waiting on her score patiently from the Interone, having won the Prix St George yesterday in a really, really strong field. It was a great win. You must be very proud of yourself there. So tell us a little bit about your team. You've got Donna Elaine, and you've got...
Well, I've still got Her Highness, Diamantina.
She's
still at
Princess.
Home. She's still at home in normal work and just staying there for now. She's 16 and I really haven't quite decided what I want to do with her. So I guess there'll come a point when I'm happy to put her in the paddock, but I'm not there yet.
She's still having foals?
We have a Diamantina Bellissimo one this year called Bruce Almighty. David Shoebridge named it Bruce Almighty. So, our little Bruce Almighty is a 26-day-old embryo at the moment.
Oh, cool.
And then Donna Elena coming up behind Diamantina. We bought her as a 4-year-old and she won Dressage with the Stars as a 5- and a 6-year-old. She's still got the highest national score for young horses from Dressage with the Stars. And then I just stayed at home and trained her for a couple of years. And she did small tour at the CDI in Sydney, the CDI in Brisbane, and now here, and was lucky enough to win at all of them. So that was great, with really amazingly good scores, 75s and 76s, and so super exciting. She's really exciting. She's the polar opposite to Diamantina. She's very calm, very easy to ride. She's great. Not far off Grand Prix.
Fantastic. Yeah. So thanks, Maree, and good luck. Good luck
Thank
with
you.
Your draw. Good luck with your score in the end
and
of one.
And my riders rep.
Oh, I now forgot
the
that.
Riders rep.
Good luck.
I'm so excited about that. I think it will be really, really interesting. I think I will learn a lot. I've had a lot of experience. You know, I spent 3 years in Europe and my whole life in the sport. So I hope I can do as good a job as Denise did and bring something to the table.
I think it's fantastic. And yep. Congratulations for all of us and everyone out there for taking on such a big responsibility. And I'm sure you'll be a great asset for all of us. So well done.
Thank you.
Groan for biting off a whole lot and get chewing.
Yes, right. Or chewed
like
up.
Like your father said.
Or chewed up, one or the other.
I'll never forget you saying that.
Yeah.
My father said to me one day, remember, if you take too big a bite, you've got to chew really quickly.
You've got to bite off more than you can chew and try not to choke. Yeah.
Well, good luck with the rise rep and congratulations. And I hope you get a great mark from Donna Elena and yep. Well done. And we look forward to seeing you at the next competition.
Thank you.
So welcome back to this fabulous competition, and we've got with us Heather Currie all the way from South Australia. Heather looking as fabulous as ever with two great stallions and a novice horse here as well that did really well. Congratulations
on
that.
Thank you.
Was he runner-up novice horse or champion novice horse?
Runner-up. He came second in both tests, and I couldn't be happier with him.
Fantastic. How good is that? It's really exciting.
It's nice for a show like this. So.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. This is no little show. And the two exciting imported stallions,
yes.
Two beautiful greys that we're all going to see at Equitana.
Yes. Well, I'm really pleased with them. I mean, Istan's only 8 years old and he's already now just had his fourth start at Grand Prix. Yes, he's making mistakes and yes, we're working our way through the test, but you know, he's got a really bright future and I really love riding and training him.
I love photographing him.
Yeah. No, he's a lot of fun and he's just got energy to burn and he's I really love him.
And the other one?
Yeah, so the other one's only recently come in from Spain. He was trained in Spain by a male rider. Now, he's a very extravagant, you know, sort of powerful horse. He's early days for our partnership. I feel like we need a little more time together yet so we can consolidate our partnership. But he's certainly, you know, exciting for the future and we'll see what we can do with him.
We're about to see CP Dresden.
Yes.
So thank you very much for your time. Good luck for the rest of the show. We might have a chat tomorrow again and we all of you guys out there, come say hello to Heather at Equitana. She's only too pleased to say hello. Great character. And congratulations for the young horse with the novice horse.
No, thank
and
you.
Good luck for the rest of the show.
Tomorrow, yeah. Thank you, Rog.
Pleasure. Thanks, Heather.
See ya.
So now we have in the arena for the second half of the Horseland CDIW Freestyle, Matthew Dowsley on AEA Prestige. I know for a fact that Matthew's most unfavourite bit of CDIW is the freestyle. He's not a great freestyle fan, but he does an amazing job. This horse won yesterday with a 72.5% and was seriously, for me, a very, very clear winner. It's a beautifully trained and beautiful horse. So, really good beginning to his test, and now into the passage. It's really expressive, super high leg, good uphill feeling, very good in PR, super sitting, good engagement, could be maybe a little stabilised in the rein contact for a few strides, but very expressive and good passage, PR, I mean. super passage. Great engagement and elegance about it. Good swing. Matthew making it look effortless and easy. Now probably back into the PR. Gently, gently, gently. And under behind. Wow. This horse is really coming into his own. So really good passage, super transition and balance, and now into the collector book. Yesterday, poor Alicia Targa got chucked off in the warm-up ring just behind these tents, and CP Dresden was having an absolute ball being free and loose. And poor Prestige got a bit of a scare with this horse running around with no rider. And so the walk was a little tense yesterday, the collector extended walk. It's a little better today, still showing a little bit of tension, but and it could reach a little bit more, but better than yesterday, so some good marks. I'm sure after yesterday's test the judges have been a very positive mind about this horse. It was very balanced and even test from beginning to end, showing lots of energy and expression and looking really effortless as it is now. Extended canter. Maybe could be a little straighter, maybe a little quarters to the right. And collected to the change. Nope, counter canter just to show the balance and control. And a half 10 meter circle of center line, and maybe a pirouette or a half pass. Half pass. Zigzag. Very good fluency. Nice rhythm behind this music for the canter beat. And again, finishing it in counter canter, just showing control. It's a similar movement to the Grand Prix, but he's got control not to do the change. Now the twos. Again, a horse that's done a handful of Grand Prix tests. So the choreography, simple, effective, and easily understandable. And wow, what a super pirouette. One and a half pirouettes. Very off the ground in the changes. Great hind leg. Could be a little bit more sitting, a little bit more uphill, but with that expression, big marks. Now the pirouette to the right. Matthew has an amazing ability to keep a horse on the hind leg. And no double pirouette, just a single one. So you still get the same mark for a single or double. So don't bite off more than you can chew. Back into passage. And into the PR. What a super test, and really technically good. But the choreography, not too super complicated. But the movements he made are going to get very good marks. This is going to be hard to beat. Certainly not as complicated as Sansets, but almost foot perfect. And a good halt to finish. Well done, Matthew.
Thank you for watching tonight's video recap with Equestrian Life. We'll see you next time.